morning to you boys and girls. It's Tuesday the 28th of February 2017. Welcome to today's United Kingdom Talk. Lots of early people with us this morning. Adam's with us bright and early. Good morning, Adam. Have you weighed yourself yet since last week? We're all very excited to tell us if you succeeded in losing another pound or a half a pound or 2 pounds this week. We're very, very excited. Guess who turned up last night, Adam, at the karaoke? Yes, only had two lovely girls, Kelly Kim and Laura. Oh, from Sunday nights. Now, just to let you know, boys and girls, advanced warning. Boom. 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 Advanced warning. Boom. Boom. Oh, I've got a little... Hang on a minute. Let me get my red flashing light. Just a moment, please. Please hold while we try and connect it. One moment, please. Just a minute. Just a minute. Here we go. Yes. We'll do that one again. We'll do that one again. Okay, advanced warning, boys and girls. Boo! Boo! Red alert! Meh! 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 Just to let you know that this coming Sunday, which is the 5th of March, it is the first Sunday of the month, so we'll be doing karaoke in South London. Now, I only do one karaoke night in South London now, boys and girls, which is at the Golden Lion in Sydenham. It's the first Sunday of the month, and it's this week, okay? So this week, it's karaoke at the Golden Lion in Sydenham between 9 p.m. and 12 midnight. Coming to you in full colour, just like this programme is. How exciting is that? So thank you, Adam. Be nice to see you. Good afternoon. Good morning to Tim, who's with us today. He said, what about Leicester City last night? Well, what happened in Leicester City? Did they open a new branch of Waitrose or John Lewis or something like that? What about Leicester City? Are you talking about the city of Leicester? Has a river burst its banks? Oh my God. Can you think of anything worse than being flooded out? People think being flooded out, you know, if you've never been flooded out or you don't know anyone, they think it's just a bit of a, you know, just a bit of water in the house. No, it's much worse than water, dear. It's the stuff that comes out your toilets as well. Yes. What comes out your bottom goes into the toilets and then comes back as flood water. You don't want to be flooded. No. On the occasions, because and I do this quite often, I always look around where my sister lives, because there's a chance at some point I'll be going to move up north. I'm not sure. I'm really not sure. I'd have to do it within 2 years, I think, if I wanted to do it, because there's little children up there. There's my nieces and nephews' children who I like to get a little bit more close to. I would, you know. So it's possible within the next couple of years. And I'm forever looking at places in sort of around her area, which is Woodall Spa. Now, the thing is, number one, it's a lot cheaper to live up there. This house is worth about £375. I could get a similar thing there, £200. £180, something like that, yeah? And you've got to be so careful. I make sure that it's not near any water. There's so many of them, and it's got a lovely picturesque little bungalow or something like that. And at the back of it, and you look out onto a lovely little stream. Well, that stream can become torrents of water, dear, in a flood. Absolutely. And it's happened up there before. A nice area up there where one of my great nieces goes to school there, Evie, is a place, I think, Kirkby by Bain. I think that's what it's called. And it's lovely there. And then you look more at the map and there's a river close by. Oh, no. We don't want dirty water in our houses, do we? No, thank you very much, Tim. So no idea what happened in Leicester City last night. I'm going to put my money on a new branch of John Lewis. Is that the sort of thing they have in Leicester, lovey? John Lewis's? good morning to Paris. Hello, Paris. Nice to see you, darling, on there. Adam says, oh, Wednesday's at 7:45 is his next weigh-in. Well, good luck with that, my darling. Incidentally, talking of weigh-ins, I've been off the crisps for a week. Not a single... I lie in your face. Oh, my God, I've just committed a sin. Sorry, I have just lied. And in front of the cross of Jesus, which is in here somewhere. There it is. It's over there. I've just lied in front of her. I had two crisps. Not two packets. Two crisps from great nephew George's crisp bag on Saturday night. Yes. Which he gave to me with his own bacteria-filled fingers. So, but that's all I've had. And do you know what, Adam? The needle has edged ever so slightly downwards. I think I've lost a quarter of a pound in weight in 1 week. That's good, isn't it? So just think, in a month, I could lose a whole pound. And I found one here. Look at this. I mean, it just gets better and better this morning. Look, I found a pound coin here. Get rid of your pound coins. If you've got any jars of these, they're going to be invalidated. So, is that the right word? Invalidated pound coins soon. They're changing all the pound coins to something which doesn't look dissimilar to a threepence, which we had years ago. I've got a threepence somewhere. I might get some old coins out to show you. They're not worth anything. The hundreds of these were printed. Unless you've got, you know, the shiny mint one in a piece of plastic that's never, ever been touched by human hands. Oh, yeah, mind you, some looking up in Sainsbury's, I don't think there's many human hands working in there, dear. Oh, miserable people. We don't like miserable people. Good morning, Tim. Yes. Thank you very much to Paul says, is it birthday or birthday? Birthday or birthday? Who cares, Paul? This is not the BBC, dear. It doesn't matter about spelling and pronunciation and things like that. We're not too worried about that, my love. As long as people can understand what I say. And it was nice to see you last night at the karaoke. Young Paul came on his own last night. Usually has two other people, but he came on his own last night. I hope you had a nice time tonight. All right, Paul. Last night. Good morning to the lovely Rory, who's with us this morning. Morning, Rory. Good old Rory. Billy Carl is there. He had his birthday recently, didn't you, Billy? Happy birthday to you. Isn't it funny, Billy, how you're about 10 years younger than me and yet look so much older, lovey? But that's the way it is. It's just the way it is. You know, it's in the genes. None of which I have on this morning. I've got tracksuit bottoms this morning, which you can't see. Sometimes I sit here completely naked from the waist down. You know, but you wouldn't know that unless I told you. It's like the whole gay issue, isn't it? You know, you wouldn't know. Because I'm quite straight acting. I'm not, pardon? I'm not really gay, am I? Not really, not unless I tell you. So this morning, can't decide what I am this morning. I'm actually going for cats this morning, not people. I'm not going for boys, girls. I'm more going for cats this morning. So I'm not quite sure that what that means. Anyway, morning, Billy. Good morning to the lovely Kelly Witt, who I saw on Sunday. Morning, Kelly. Grant's there as well. Hello, Grant. What's happening in October, Grant? It says in October. What's happening in October? Do tell us. Paris says, can I have the pound? I'm broke. Well, I don't know about that, my love. You want this pound coin, dear? But what will I eat? What will I eat if I send you this pound coin, my love? I think I'm going to have to say no to that. I'm sorry, Paris, lovey. I'm going to have to say no to you having my pound or my BBC badge, as provided by the great Ray Reynolds, who purchased me this badge on his most recent trip to the BBC. Yes, they're always on the phone, dear. Oh, hello. Could you come and do a show for us? Well, I've got to do my own show. Thank you very much. And I put the show down. Put the phone down immediately, yes. Sorry, Paris, you can't have that, darling. Tim says, carpool karaoke spreading even to the ML Major League Soccer. We're not interested in football, Tim. I can't think of anything more boring than playing a game of football. All these little poofters running around on a field, kicking a ball towards each other, and then they kiss each other and get in the bath together. I'm sorry, what is all that about? Donald Trump isn't... It's all fake news. It's all fake. It's all fake. Donald Trump's not going to allow that anymore. Men in swimming pools together. It's disgusting. It's outrageous. Jesus Christ and Mary, how will it all go, dear? Donald, it's all fake news. It's fake news. Fake news. Rory says he's making a comeback soon. Well, hurry up, dear. Hurry up. We're waiting for you. Rory, my stage is empty without you. It's very full when you're on it, but it's empty when you're not there. Please, Rory, come down. We need the top of the Irish. We got no Irish singing at Chris Riordan's karaoke night, and it just doesn't seem right. Yes. Thank you, Grant. Grant says you've got to use these pound coins by October. All right, use the pound coins by October. Paris says, can she eat the cat? Well, if you want to, darling. She's a bit old now, though, my cat, my love. There's no struggling involved when you play with her or pick her up. She don't struggle. She just puts up with everything now. bless her, she's coming up to 19 years old, my cat. She goes round and round in circles lots of the time. Round and round she goes, honestly. Tim says, new karaoke booth developed in China. Looks like a Doctor Who capsule. Ooh, I'll have to look at that. I can't look at that at the moment, Tim, but I will have a look at that. Thank you very much. Poor little cat. It's October the 16th, Tim says, which is my mum's birthday. The day to use your £1 coins. Yes, indeed. And talking to birthdays, that'll be coming up a little bit later. Your birthdays this morning, boys and girls. There is a phone number open as well if you want to call in at some point this morning about anything at all. I'll give you a couple of subjects in a minute. The phone number is up there now if you're watching the live show. If you're watching a recording, the phone number isn't there because obviously you can't record. You can't phone if you're watching a recording, okay? Phone number's up there, 020-814-3477. There's also a Skype in as well. Oh, actually, I haven't put the Skype up, have I? Just a second. Don't call in yet. Hang on. I haven't switched on the phone. Ooh, did you see that? All I've got to do is push one button and the phone comes live. It takes a little bit of a time to fire up. Come on, up you come. Do you wish sometimes you could actually see what's going on the screens in front of me? I could put another camera over there, actually. Would you like that? To actually see what's going on. I could do that at some point, actually. Yeah, I'll do that when we change the background because we've got a lovely new bright blue background coming round. Okay, that's on its way. Okay, oh, of course it wants to update now. Never mind. Let's talk a bit more and then you can call in if you want to. Now, I don't know, did anyone see... Oh, hang on. Oh, that's the other thing this morning. I rang up the doctors this morning. I've got... And I've had for a while a bit of a red throat right at the back. It's really red and itchy ears inside. And I asked for an... OK, that phone line's open now. All right, phone line's open now. That's all right now. That's working now. I've had the itchy ears for a number of weeks. So I thought, oh, I better ring up and ask him about it. And I said, could I have an appointment? She said, what I'll do is I'll get the doctor to ring you and then he can decide whether you need an appointment or not. Explain to him on the phone what was what. And he said, right, I'll prescribe you some antibiotics and some nasal spray. He said, do you get guitar in your throat? Well, I've had that for years. Now, that is, I'm going to make a noise now, which doesn't sound very pleasant. This is guitar. Okay? That's guitar. Usually you won't hear that because I've got a button here and I will sniff. And you'll know I'm doing it because you can see it. If I put that sniffer. Okay, it's really unpleasant to hear. That's guitar. Now he's going to send me, he's going to prescript me as well. He's going to put on the prescription as well. Some sort of nasal spray, which he says you won't feel the benefit for a number of weeks. You've got to keep doing it, but then it will start working. So I wonder if that will cure up this permanent problem I've had with that guitar business, which is just not very pleasant at all. But all that was done without actually going to see him. I suppose that saves them quite a lot of time, really, doesn't it? And it saves you from leaving the house. Not only that, I don't actually have to go into the doctor's surgery. He just pushes a few buttons and the prescription goes straight over to the chemist, which I got the chemist in Bracknell here. We've got lots of chemists in Bracknell. My local one, which is Lloyd's, and it goes straight there. Isn't that clever? I haven't got to deliver any bits of paper. I wonder, actually, how long that takes. So if he sent that over this morning, would that be there by this afternoon, or does it still take a couple of days? You know, they're all very funny with this administration, aren't they? It's like the banks. You know, when you put a cheque in, why does that take 3 or 4 days to clear? What's all that about? You know, it's only someone's pushed a button, bang, the money's there. Oh, let's hold on to this for 3 days. We'll get some interest. Now, you may think that £50 cheque that you just put in, oh, it's not much interest on that. Yeah, times that by all the other £50 cheques that have gone in. Hundreds of them, dear, hundreds. Yes. Paris says, just mum, that Sharon, has just woke up. Oh, come on, Sharon. Wakey, wakey, dear. Have you got the phone near her or your iPad or whatever it is you're watching us on? Put the phone near your mother. Let's wake her up together. Yes. Good morning to Rod Brown, who's sorting out his diet plan for Lent. Excellent. Because it's Shrove Tuesday today, boys and girls. Oh, yes. Shrove Tuesday today. Time to get those pancakes I've got downstairs. I've cheated a little bit. Ready-made pancakes. Ready-made pancakes, which actually are very nice. You just shove them in the microwave about 30 seconds and they're delicious. And I only have a little bit of sugar and a little bit of lemon on. Talking of sugar, I add sugar to absolutely nothing except pancakes. That's the only thing I add sugar to. What about you? Do you add sugar to everything? Come on, tell me what you're adding the sugar to this morning. Good morning. Who's on the line, please?
It's Grant.
Good morning, Grant. That's my very good... DJ Grant is in the house, in the place to be. Look at me now, Grant. From little old DJ to international television personality. Good morning.
Good morning.
Now, what are you calling in about today? A pound coin. You want this pound coin, don't you?
No. You were talking about the prescription going to your chemist.
Yes.
Well, it should be there within a few minutes.
Oh, really? As quick as that? So I should be able to get. I should be able to get that this afternoon.
Yes.
Oh, well, that's handy. Yeah, infection, back of throat and inside the ears. Do you get that much?
No.
Oh, it's horrible. Oh, horrible, horrible. It's bright red, the back of my throat. Awful. Never mind. Now, do you add sugar to everything? I bet yours. You seem to be the sort of... Oh, I'm going to sneeze now. It's all going wrong here. Oh, no. Can you talk for a minute while I sneeze?
Oh, God.
No, it's not coming.
What do you want to
say? It's not coming, Grant. It's not coming. Oh, no. Lord. No. What do you add sugar to? Anything?
No, I don't have sugar in anything. I don't even drink Coke with sugar in anymore.
Very good. Our good friend, and you've probably heard him on the phone a few times now, used to be addicted to Coca-Cola. Adam the plumber?
Yes.
Yeah, he wouldn't mind you telling me this. He wouldn't mind me telling you this. He was totally addicted to Coca-Cola. 3 or 4 litres a day. You know those big bottles? He'd have 4 of those a day. Terrible, isn't it? That's why he went on the diet, but he is succeeding slowly. Mind you, look at those eyes. Now, Grant, I've got to tell you, boys and girls, Grant used to be assistant. Let's put you up a bit. Grant used to be area manager of a little pub that I used to work in Clapham. And on a Sunday night, we'd both been out the night before at a lovely little club in London, which no longer exists, called Chariots.
Yeah.
And on the Sunday night, we would be at work quite tired and not quite with it. And halfway through the night, we would go to Kentucky Fried Chicken. You know those big tubs of ice cream? Serves 8. We'd get 2 of those and have the whole thing each. You remember the Rolo ice creams? They were nice, weren't they?
Yes, very nice.
I think they were about £4 each in there or something. I'm sure you didn't give me the money for those. You must owe me for some ice cream.
You must
owe me for some ice cream. I don't remember receiving the money for those ice creams.
Yes, but I talked to you. That made up for it.
Did it really? Roller. Honestly, great big tubs of... And we'd have one of those every week, wouldn't we?
Yes.
That was after our visit to the baked potato shop down the road where I would have, because I was eating meat at the time... I would have jacket potato with chili con carne and cheese on the top, and Grant would have 2 sausages. Sausages! Sausages!
Oh,
happy days!
Chicken and vegetables.
Chicken and vegetables. How long ago was that now?
Oh, 5 years now.
Gosh. Where that time's gone, isn't it? We did have a laugh Sunday night.
I haven't been to the Brewers for over 4 years.
What, you haven't actually been in there at all?
No.
Okay, well, I just do the one night a week, which I quite like. Yeah. I quite like doing the Thursday night. It is quite an easy night, really. Just turning up at 10 and finishing at 2. Are you doing any DJing now?
Yes, I DJ at the Jordan Dragon in Greenwich. I've been there 2 years now.
And what days is that?
Between Fridays and Saturdays.
Do you do both days or do you alternate?
Mainly Fridays, but sometimes Saturdays.
Oh, okay. Does anyone else who else DJs there then?
DJ Spark.
Is that Gary?
No, it's Stuart now.
That's a different person, is it?
No, it's Gary, but he's called Stuart.
Oh, what's all that about then?
Call me when you're off air and I'll tell you.
Has he had to change his name for some sort of legal purposes?
Yes.
Oh, you must tell me about that. All right, then. Well, can you send him my very best regards? He's a nice lad, he is. Yeah, tell him I said hello, all right?
I will. Okay.
Thank you very much, Grant, for calling in. Cheerio. Bye-bye. There we are. Grant calling in from a very posh... He's from Greenwich. Greenwich. Oh, it's posh there. I could never afford to live there, dear. Just a moment. That's that one there. There we are. So do you... Here's the question. Oh, well, let's go back to some of these messages for you this morning. Favourite pancake filling? Nutella, other chocolate spreads are available. No, I don't go along with pancake fillings. No, to me, pancakes are a little bit of sugar and a little bit of lemon on the top. If you want to go out and have a filled pancake, that's okay, but not today. Shrove Tuesday, it doesn't sound right to me. We never had fillings as a child. Never had pancake fillings as children. Banana mash and chocolate this and this, that and the other. No, it was just sugar and lemons on there. Thank you for that, Tim. What do you have in your pancake? Let me know. Put a message on here or send or give us a ring. 020-8144-3477. What is your favourite pancake filling? And what do you add sugar to? Huh? What do you add sugar to? The only thing I add sugar to is on the top of pancakes today on Shrove Tuesday. Oh, yes. With my ready-made pancakes in a packet. Shove them in the microwave for like 20 seconds. Bing! Oh, so tasty and nice. Actually, my mate's coming round this afternoon. I hope I've got enough for two of us. Oh, dear. I hope isn't going to want more than one out of that packet of six. Oh, dear. Ah, good morning. Sharon's watching us as well this morning. Good morning, Sharon Stoned. All right, my darling. Nice to see you. Tim says he's on Skype for web now. Can't connect via the tablet for some reason. Oh, well, not to worry. You're there. You're there. Can we have a video of me making pancakes? No, because I won't be making them, Adam. I won't be making the pancakes. This is a thing. They're already done in a packet. Just open the packet and that's it. They come out of the packet, shove them in the microwave, bing! Just a few moments later. How marvellous. Let's have a look there. All right, 020-8144-3477 is the phone number. Now, last night, I got in last night. Is there a visitor in my house? Hello? Is that you, dear? I am talking, dear. I've only done 22 minutes. God's sake. Oh, my mate's all right. He might pop in. If you're coming in, bring the stool from the bathroom. Then you can join in tonight's global broadcast around millions of people all over the world. Now, last night I got home after karaoke. Very good night again last night. I've got to tell you, karaoke. Oh, need to tell you. If you're a karaoke regular at Central Station, Friday is Maureen's birthday party. Okay, ooh, so Friday's ooh. Maureen's birthday party. Hello. Ooh. What? Is it hot in here?
Yeah, just come to check
my hair. It's the television studio lights.
You mean the two light bulbs?
Eh?
Two light bulbs.
They can't see you, look. It's just a head. There you are, look at that. There. It's best friend Ron with his little Eskimo hood. Look at this old cheap jacket that he's got on. Cheap, dear, cheap. Look, 101 things you can do with a cat when it's dead. Oh, yes. That's what we like. What?
This little bedroom, could you have to do an Uber?
Television studio, how dare you, dear?
Spare bedroom.
It's not spare bedroom.
Spare bedroom.
It's not spare bedroom. Apparently, someone rung in and said that prescription, because he sent it straight... Oh, have I told you this?
No.
Oh, so the doctor rung up?
Oh, yeah, he sends it electronically to the...
Yeah, I haven't got to go and see him. He's given me antibiotics and a nasal spray, which will hope...
What, it must be like a traffic cone for the size of your nose.
Are you making tea? You can join us. Do you want to join us in here and be insulted?
I think that
they're probably not interested in what you've got to say anyway.
They're always interested in what I've got to say.
Nothing interesting to say in the world, dear.
Interesting person.
Not interesting
you,
person.
Crisps on the floor.
Where's the crisps on the floor?
No,
where are crisps on the floor?
Something you used to talk about.
There are no crisps on the floor.
No, there's a bit of a dodgy umbrella.
I've taken my umbrellas off, look. Because it was too bright for that background, but that'll change soon when it goes. That's all going blue, light blue, like that colour. A bit lighter than that colour. Would you like that? Don't touch our Barry. Don't touch Barry Manilow.
And this?
That is my star of fame, presented to Chris Reardon on the occasion of placement of your star on the Star of Fame database. Thank you.
Yeah, but you're,
Christmas
yeah, but,
2015.
Yeah, but it means nothing. Same as having a badge, BBC badge.
BBC badge.
It means nothing.
They haven't seen that.
Nothing.
That's not for you to
it
show.
It means
them,
nothing. Then. Just because you've got a badge, it doesn't mean you work for them. You need a contract. Oh, is that $5? I need
no,
to go
no,
to
no,
America.
No,
I'm going
no.
to America.
You don't have it, my dollars. Get off! Oh, it's Adam the plumber. Hang on. Good morning, Adam the plumber. Look, you've adjusted. You've knocked my ball.
Good morning, Chris.
Hi, Adam. Hello, you've obviously Ronny, rang up to speak to me.
Sorry?
You've obviously rang up to speak to me.
Yes, of course. Yes, I was just going to say, Ronny, can you go downstairs and get the hoover if you're going to complain about Chris's carpet, please, and start hoovering it?
Yeah, so there you go. So don't just complain, do something about it. Go and get the hoover.
Well, it's only a spare bedroom. It'll take about 2 minutes.
It's not like this is a television studio.
I can stretch from one wall to the other with my arms. You could do it with your nose.
Well, when you can lift them up and they're not hurting you.
I take it you're in the satellite studio today, Chris, and not the main studio.
No, we're in the smaller studio today. They're all...
There's only one studio. And it's tiny.
I'll have tea, please. Thank
spare
you.
Bedroom.
Tea. Thank you, tea.
Who is it who came round? Some woman came round for an interview.
What?
And you said, come up to the studio.
Oh, that was Nikki French.
Nikki French.
Eurovision entrant in 19-something. Yes. Yeah. She came round here. Did you know that, Adam?
Just about fitted two people in here.
I did, yes.
All the
stars in here.
They've all been here, dear. They've all been here, honestly, ringing up all the time.
Nikki French and, of course, the lovely Kelly Wilde.
They've all been here in the Mirabelle Studios. Thank you.
Sue Ellen nearly made an appearance, but unfortunately she had to rush off because she'd heard that JR had been dug up.
That's right.
He said what?
He's just talking about my personal friend, Sue Ellen. That's Linda Gray from Dallas.
You know, she
Linda
actually Gray. Took out an injunction on Chris Reardon because he was...
Personal
you know,
friend,
harassing
Linda Gray.
Linda harassing. Gray,
my personal friend. Thank harassing. You. Ba-ba-ba-ba. Here, just before you go, are you going to make tea?
I might.
Did you see that programme last night with David Williams?
No.
Oh, it was hideous. Absolutely hit. You know David Williams from Little
Britain.
Yes,
he's a personal friend of mine on Facebook.
He's not a person. Well, have you ever spoken to him?
Of course I have. many
occasions.
No,
you haven't spoken to him. You haven't spoken to him.
On many occasions.
No stars are your... You only know celebrities. People like the only way is Essex.
No, I don't
X Factor contestants.
No.
X-rated celebrities. That's sort of the only sort of people you know. I know stars. Linda Gray.
You don't know her.
Is Ronny one of these people that has that pays these stars to be on his Facebook?
As the what?
Chris gets them naturally. You see.
Thank you. There you go.
No.
You see.
No.
Thank you very much.
I don't.
Sorry.
You can actually do that. You can actually pay to have celebrity. You can actually pay to have celebrities on your.
I don't have to pay any celebrities on my wall. The ones that add me. I don't have to, you know, pay them.
I have so I'm busy this weekend. No, I'm sorry, darling. Maybe another week. Thank you. Bye-bye, Kylie. But what did you say?
The phone never even rang.
Of course it did. A little light illuminates. You don't have ringing telephones in studios.
It's not a studio.
You have a light that flashes, dear. I've, no idea. How would you know? You're not into television like me.
You're not into television.
Personality
and all these wires under here. You don't see those on the BBC when it pans round.
Of course you do. They can't see. Can they see any wires? Look, can you see any wires anywhere?
What's that, it's all hidden. It's a cassette.
It's a cassette tape. Have you been to the BBC ever? No.
Yes, I have.
What did you go and
on
see?
On two occasions,
what did you go
I was
and
on
see?
The television. I done the gay version of Blind Date.
Oh, it's all gay in it. Gay.
And I also done another thing for a pilot, and I had Terry Wogan's dressing room, actually. Oh. And I did something very naughty in there.
Ah, talking to Terry Wogan, I sat in his chair at the BBC Broadcasting House a few years ago when I was doing my demo tape for Liberty Radio in 1999. Thank you very much.
How long ago was that? 17 years?
1999.
Yeah, I got to use his dressing room. Did you use his dressing room? Did you use his equipment?
Didn't need to. You sit in the dressing room, I'll sit in the chair and do the show. Thank you very much.
YouTuber.
There's no YouTubing.
YouTuber.
Thank you. I'll make some tea now. Thank you very much. That's it. Sorry about that interruption, boys and girls, for that complete...
That's all right.
I mean, talk about take the show downhill. Do you know what I mean?
Indeed.
Take the
Indeed.
Show downhill. Anyway, how are you today, Adam? What's... Shut up!
Go and tell him to go and do some hoovering or something. Or go and grab a duster.
Oh, you can't lift the hoover. It's too heavy for him. You know that gay version of Blind Date? They're apparently there. Do you remember that? Yeah, I went through that. I went for that, and apparently I was too straight acting. Didn't get it.
Sounds
I was
about
too
right.
straight acting. What are you calling in for today, Adam?
Just to say good morning, and Ronnie's totally thrown me off what I was going to say now, so I can't remember.
Oh, the other phone's ringing. Just a moment, please. Hello?
That's Ronny.
Sharon? No, you got the wrong number. Thank you, bye-bye. Someone wanted to speak to Sharon. That's my sister. She don't live here. How strange and mysterious. This is a strange show today. It's not really flowing, is it? It's not flowing at all. There's all these interruptions. The amount of time that I spend preparing this worldwide phenomenon known as United Kingdom Talk is unbelievable. Only to be torn apart by idiots that ring up on my house phone and people that interrupt into the TV studio. Usually, you know, I lock my gate and my front door downstairs just in case we're taken over halfway through the show.
I can't believe Ronnie just walks into religious your extremists. House now and makes himself tea.
I know. It's outrageous.
And uses your downstairs toilet. Thank goodness he doesn't use your upstairs
Then. Am I going to sneeze? No, I'm not going to sneeze. Oh, dear. Never mind. You didn't watch any telly last night, did you?
No. I was working late last night down in Brighton. Removing graffiti.
Oh, I didn't know you. Do you do that as well, do you?
Yeah, because I've got a high-pressure jetting unit that I clean the drains.
I think it has to be said, there's like graffiti and there's graffiti. And some of these people who do graffiti are very, very... He's singing downstairs. Can you hear that or not?
I can't hear him from here.
Oh, probably good as well. Anyway, there's graffiti. Some of these graffiti people are really good at what they do, don't you think?
I do
just
like
just close this door.
Graffiti on that's out there. I particularly like Banksy, actually. I like some of his work.
Oh, right, yes.
Yeah, I've got his books at home. And, I've got a few of his ones that have been copied of his, like the Kissing Policeman. And a few of the others, I think they're quite interesting and different.
You're going to have to nick a couple of his pictures that he puts up everywhere. You have to remove doors and walls and things like that to get them, don't you?
Yeah, that's right. Holes in walls to remove them before.
You'd probably be very good at that, Adam.
there is actually one in Brighton. There's one in Brighton just by the railway station. It's the Two Kissing Policemen one.
Oh, right, yes.
Yeah, it's the Two Kissing Policemen. And then that was... He replicated that actually on a building down on the Old Steam, but near the Old Steam for Pride, and it suddenly appeared.
I'm with you.
it was one of his ones that appeared.
Okay, I haven't seen that one at all.
Yeah, it's really good that one. But I was ringing in to say if you need my services, I'm free for the next couple of weekends, not this weekend, but next weekend if you're. Redesigning or changing the studio, and you need my my screwdriver and my drill.
Your screwdriver and drill is all available. Lovey.
I'd come up for a cup of coffee and chat, you know.
All I'm doing is, when the stuff arrives, is changing behind that and then moving everything across a bit. But I don't know if I'm going to be able to put that picture up anyway. It's a bit too big. I might have a look around for something smaller. I think we need a picture of some sort at the back there, and then we can keep changing it now and again to give it a little bit of variety.
What about that lovely Thames television picture you had?
Yes, I've got that. But again, that's it's quite long, you see. That we've only got, even if I move everything over, I still don't think I could squash it up a bit more, but then it's going to be look a bit jumbled up, isn't it? I'll see what happens. I won't know. I'll move everything over.
Maybe a complete set redesign.
Eh?
Maybe a complete set redesign, because when you had the blackout back in 2011 or 12, you had the Queen hanging on the background as well. Do you remember?
Yes, the Queen in the Union Jack.
That's all right. Yeah.
Yeah. That was for her. Was it a diamond jubilee, something like that?
It was one of the jubilees, wasn't it? It was all that sort of time of the Olympics and her anniversary and a few other bits. There was so much going on that year.
That's right.
Couldn't keep up with it.
God, it's so long ago, I tell you. Oh, something else I've got to do. Just before I started the show today, it came up. You know, the broadcast software is now offering an update. And I thought, do it now, just before the show? And I thought, no. So I'll leave that to you tonight. I'll do it tonight and then get it nice and working. Because often you do these updates and it completely throws everything else out, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. We've had experience of updates on your PC before.
Oh, gosh. Well, thanks, Adam. You have a lovely day. Thanks for calling in.
And you, Chris. Bye-bye.
Always a pleasure. Oh, I forgot to put your photo up. Never mind. Next time you ring up, can you say, don't forget my photo, then I'll remember.
All right, don't forget my photo. Chris, don't forget my photo.
I'll tell you what, we'll just put it up very quickly, very, very quickly now for the last few seconds
of
your call.
Cat, and you're into cats today, so...
Adam and his cat. You only see the photo, incidentally, if you're watching a live show, OK? There we are. Thank you, Adam.
Cheers, Chris.
Have a nice day. Bye-bye now. Adam the plumber, boys and girls, if you need any work done. He doesn't just do plumbing. He does all sorts of stuff. All right, that's the man for you. He won't rip you off, I promise you. Anyway, just talking a little while Ronny was in the room last night. I got home from the karaoke last night. I thought I'd just watch a bit of television. So I made myself a cup of tea and I had a piece of wholemeal toast with butter and marmalade on it. But no crisps. No crisps. There's been no crisps recently. And I put on the telly and I'd heard about this show called The Nightly Show, which has been advertised quite a lot. ITV have been pushing this thing. And I thought, I'll give that a watch. So I fired up my ITV Hub thing. The thing is with that ITV Hub, why isn't it anywhere near as good as the BBC iPlayer? Have you noticed that? The picture quality is a little bit rank in it. And it's just, it's messy. It's messy, this thing, and it just doesn't look professional. Mind you, that whole ITV logo thing looks like something that a child has written. I mean, it really does. Anyway, so I put on this programme and fired up the Nightly Show. And I didn't know who was hosting it, funnily enough, but it was that David Walliams. Now, I thought to myself, oh, don't know about that, because he done an interview recently on the BBC with Shirley Bassey. Now, did you see that at Christmas? Dave, it was either, you know, Dame Shirley Bassey's birthday hosted by David Walliams. And it was basically a chat show. And he just can't do it. Just doesn't work. It really doesn't work. Now, as an entertainment type person in the Little Britain series, he was excellent. You know, funny, the da-da-da-da-da and all that business. But as a chat show host, I didn't find him very good on the Dame Shirley Bassey show. So I put it on last night, you know, with eager anticipation. I thought, well, this will probably be good. And as soon as he appeared on there, I thought, oh, no. And I managed 10 minutes of it. I managed 10 minutes of it. And it was a blatant try at copying The Tonight Show with... various people over the years. Here's Johnny. Remember that thing in America? It was a blatant try at copying that. And it just didn't work. The audience are all there standing up. They're not sitting down. What's all that about? The audience are standing up, clapping. Ha, 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 ha. No, not for me, I'm afraid. And for that, they've moved News at 10. Not that anyone watches that anymore. Not since they completely and utterly ruined that years ago when they first moved it from 10 o'clock. Now, the ITV News at 10 used to be ITN News at 10. OK, same thing. Years ago, this was renowned the world over, the ITN News at 10. And then some dimwit years ago decided to move it from 10 o'clock till 10:30 or thereabouts, depending what time the programme before finished. So it lost its regular slot, along with all the viewers. The BBC, at that time, they had their main news at 9 o'clock. So you had the BBC News at 9, the ITV News at 10. And it's always worth watching both. They are both similar stories, but not exactly the same. The moment ITV moved their 10 o'clock news, the BBC jumped in there and said, OK, well, we'll move ours from 9 till 10 now to fill in the gap. And it worked. For them, it worked. And the whole ITV news thing went down and down and down. And it is just such a faded thing now to what it once was. Mind you, the whole of ITV is, I find. And some idiot that... idiot that moved that 10 o'clock news to 10:30 years ago. Anyway, they moved it back to 10 o'clock after years. But you see, the horse has bolted. Everyone's gone now. They're not going to come back. So that was it. Ruined. Now they've moved it back to 10:30. I had no idea what they're doing. I don't know who's running it. Anyway, back to this programme last night. The Nightly Show, David Walliams. I watched 10 minutes of it. That's all I managed. Awful. absolutely ghastly. He is completely the wrong person to be hosting a chat show. I know that he wants to get somewhere like that, but it's just not working, David. I'm sorry. It's not funny. You come across as smarmy, not really friendly, too laid back, not doing it for me. Maybe you saw it and you thought differently. Or what did you think? Why don't you call in and tell me about it? If you watched the nightly show with David Williams last night, did you see it? What did you think of it? 020-8144-3477. Or if you're watching a recording of the show, just put a little message underneath. Or you could send in an email if you want to, chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. 020-8144-3477. Just a reminder, gang, if you send messages in or emails, then I do read them out in the next show or perhaps the one after sometimes if we're a little bit busy, all right? In the Daily Mail this morning, here we go. It riled up people the wrong way before it had even started. And sadly, for ITV, the network's newest chat show, The Nightly Show has left an even bitterer taste in viewers' mouths following its debut transmission on Monday night, last night. Airing at 10 o'clock at night, the programme, here we go, which this is exactly what I've just, I haven't read this yet actually, I'm reading this straight off before. This is exactly what I just said to you. Airing at 10 o'clock, the programme, which is supposed to emulate the likes of The Late Show or Jimmy Kimmel Live in the States with its weekly nighttime slot, has booted the hallmark ITV News at 10 out of its seemingly permanent evening slot. So that this is the second time they've done that. It's the second time they've done that. With the news shoved into the later 10:30 slot, The Nightly Show was created to provide a late night series fronted by a different host each week with guests, laughs and topical chit chat. But it would seem ITV have failed to deliver on their promise, leaving viewers raging at the fact that their beloved 10 o'clock news fix has been shunted for a turkey. Now, I didn't know that. So it's going to be a different host every week, is it? Okay. Well, I didn't know that. I didn't know that. It's not going to be David Williams all the time. Maybe the next one will be better. You know, let's have someone of decency hosting some of this stuff. Can't we? I mean, someone like, obviously he can't do it because he's still not well, is he? But someone like Bruce Forsyth with a bit of personality, with a bit of believable personality. You know? There's a couple of people actually on BBC Breakfast News that could do something like this. That always comes across as kind of friendly and relaxed, doesn't it? Hmm? Slamming it as unfunny and dire, Twitter people said the verdict was in on Williams' opening episode. Here's some of the tweets that came in. Nightly Show is truly awful. Gut-wrenching rubbish. Martin Clunes is virtually incoherent. I didn't see him. Pathetic drivel turned it off, came the first scathing tweet, slamming not only Williams, but his debut guest, Martin Clunes. Another one. Gave Nightly Show 15 minutes and it's absolutely rubbish. Script infantile and unfunny. Williams untalented. Well, he is. He is talented, but not in that sphere. It's a bit like me. I might be able to talk, but don't try and ask me to play a football game. I can't kick a football and I can't draw pictures. Honestly, I cannot draw pictures to save my life. I cannot do art. You have to find what you're sort of reasonable at. I think I'm reasonable at having a little bit of a chat with people. Williams is reasonable and very good at making people laugh in his little comedy sketches that he used to do. But the chat show host thing is just not doing it for him. He's been given the wrong job. And besides, why don't they give it to someone new? I'm sick to death of seeing the same people all the time. We've got another quiz show coming up on Thursday. Who's hosting it? Have a guess. Go on. Have a wild stab in the dark. Oh, yes. Philip Schofield again. I mean, why don't you just give him his own channel? There's nothing wrong with Philip Schofield. Very talented and he can do anything that's thrown at him. He's really good. But I just get sick to death of seeing the same face. Philip Schofield, Holly Willoughby, Ben, he's on in the morning and he does a couple of chat shows as well. Sick of seeing the same people. Why can't you give it to one person? Different people. The bloke who does the the quiz show at night time on ITV. He only does one thing. You never get tired of seeing him. He does just a couple of things here and there, doesn't he? What was his name? Oh, he's very funny. I can't remember his name for a minute. You only see one now and again, then it's okay. But they keep shoving on the same people all the time. Ben Shepherd, that was it. Ben Shepherd was the Ben one. Anyway, so we carry on. A fourth tweetster posted, question for ITV bosses. Was it worth disrupting news at 10 for the nightly show? Last time it was Bond films. Didn't work then either. Which was echoed by another who typed, I've put my news back to where it belongs and don't insult me with the rubbish that is the nightly show. Referencing drama series Broadchurch, which returned for its third series at 9 o'clock on the same channel, someone else wrote, how can you go from the excellence of Broadchurch to the showing of the absolutely dire nightly show? And it's just shocking. So I don't know what you thought about that. The big boys at ITV will surely be ruffled by the audience reaction. I mean, who's running this bloody this channel now? It's absolutely dire. That and the crap on ITV BE. Oh, God. Best housewives doing this and screaming and shouting at each other. The big boys at ITV will surely be ruffled by the audience reaction, with guest hosts such as Gordon Ramsay, John Bishop and Melon Sue. Gordon Ramsay hosting a chat show? Okay, well, let's see how he does. I haven't seen him do that before. Maybe he'd be really good here. I'm glad to see they're trying out new people. Very good. Very good. Mel and Sue, I reckon they'll do all right. They're all lined up to take the reins in the coming weeks. Convinced that, quote, young people don't like news bulletins anymore, unquote, ITV director of television... Well, it's all fake news, isn't it? Donald Trump said that. Fake news. ITV are just telling fake news. None of it's true. There is no row with the Russian people. There's no row. King Jing Jong Jing of North Korea, he doesn't do anything wrong. He's a nice person. A nice person. It's all fake news. Don't believe any of it. There is no climate change. Go on, turn your car and just leave it running for hours on end. There is no climate change. Fake news, dear. Fake news. This ITV's director of television, Kevin Liger. Oh, but he's important. Very, very important person, aren't you? Walking around with your clipboard. I'm very important, but I'm director of ITV. The trouble is, I can't get anything right. We wanted to try something new that will effectively extend the primetime entertainment feel of ITV. What? That an X Factor? Do us a favour, will you? Well, at least you've got the voice. That's decent. The voice is all right. I like the voice. What I like about the voice is that they don't insult or have a go at the contestants. They are constructive. Not all of us wants to see people shouting and screaming at other people and then having a go at them. Jeremy Kyle, X Factor, what's the other one? Only Ways Essex, Real Housewives of this, that and the other, Big Brother, all crap. I don't watch any of that. Dreadful, ghastly programmes, ghastly. Billed as a smart, sharp, fun half-hour entertainment show. Really? I tell you what, I will try and watch the rest of it and I'll comment tomorrow, okay? Nightly show executive producer has said of the series, which has been trialled on an 8-week run, it's a great time for satire. Really? You think so, do you? It's rubbish. Get it off. Get it off. For God's sake, man, it's not funny at all. So I don't know if any of you saw that at all last night. Hello to David Anthony, who's with us this morning. Good morning, David. Hope you're well, sir. All right. Nice to see you. Ricky's got the voice. Ricky. Do you know what? I haven't seen that, David. I've actually got about 5 voices now lined up, along with 5 Let It Shines on my hard disk recorder thing. I've got loads and loads to watch at the moment. Tim says you can compare the nightly show with the performance of Liverpool against Leicester. What about Liverpool? You know I don't do football, Tim. We don't do football, I'm afraid. It's all fake news. Fake news, David. Fake news. Paris says boom shakala. Pete Brance says I rarely watch UK television now. I'm not surprised, Pete. I mean, it all went wrong since Dallas finished. Now, Dallas was an excellent programme. And I, as you know, I'm personal friends with Linda Gray from Dallas. Yes, I met her once for approximately 30 seconds outside the back of Wimbledon Theatre. There's even an interview with me, with Linda Gray. Have you seen that yet, Pete? Oh, dear, dear me. You'll have to search for that one. If you type in YouTube, United Kingdom Talk, Linda Gray, you might find it on there. I think that might bring it up. United Kingdom Talk, Linda Gray. Try that one. Or United Kingdom Talk, Dallas. Something like that, okay? let me just scroll down there. Oh, yes, you've put so many messages there. 1 second. Oh, scrolling down. There we are. That's better. Here we are. Ah, Sharon says on the subject of the pancakes, she's already had homemade pancakes with syrup and lemon. Oh, Sharon, you should have invited me round. I would have come round for those pancakes. Very, very nice indeed. Tim says, the nightly show, totally agree with you, Chris, even though I've not seen the programme. To move news at 10 is a disgrace. Well, they do that. I don't know why they do that. They always try and fix something that's not broken. I've had that done to me many years. When I've run a night for a couple of years and some bonzo decides to come in and try and change it when it's working. Do you know the times that's happened to me? Particular moments were a night I was doing at Heaven. A packed room. Packed! You couldn't get a cigarette paper in between the people that were in that room. And we just paid pop stuff. And then one day, the owner came in. David Inches was his name. And says, well, you've done really well in here, Chris. We want to try you to do something else now. But it's working. But of course, you can't say that because that's the governor. So you just go along with it. And it killed it. Stone dead. Killed it. 6 weeks later. Job gone, because they'd all gone, because some idiot had interfered with it. I used to do Monday night at the Black Cap, an excellent 70s and 80s night. And then they decided, it was just me and the music, that was it, packed to the rafters. This is in the 90s. And then someone said, oh, we're going to introduce a couple of drag queens to host the night. Well, why? It works. Well, these drag queens came, one was okay, but the other one, oh, the attitude stank. And she really upset a lot of people. Anyway, they got rid of that one eventually. But I don't understand why people try and fix things that aren't broken. Morning to Katie Bonwick, who's with us this morning. Morning, Peter. And Pete, of course, is in Brazil. You were watching the karaoke last night, weren't you, Pete? I did see your pop-up, and I hope you enjoyed that last night. Sharon says, I didn't burn the pancakes. I can, well, it is easy to burn pancakes, actually, isn't it? I know it is. Little Britain was brilliant, says Tim, but this was only when I got the DVDs. I enjoyed Little Britain. I thought it was very funny. My favourite character was the big lady. Call me Bubbles, darling. Bubbles De Vere. Call me Bubbles, darling. Call me Bubbles. That was my favourite character on there. Yeah. Tim Partington says, Williams and Friend, which was his recent comedy sketch show, was brilliant in places. Loved the operatic singer. Yeah, the sketch shows for him work, don't they? They do. Katie liked Little Britain. Tim says, BBC gets more viewers now than ITV for the news shows. Well, they have done for some time, I think, to be honest. What's wrong with Brucey? No one knows, really, Sharon. Bruce has been out of the picture now for a year and a half. A long time now. No one's saying anything. But I don't think he's too well. Hopefully, he'll be back on the mend. I'd like to see... Do you know what I'd like to see Bruce Forsyth do? One more series of The Generation Game. I'd like to see them bring him back for just one more series of The Generation Game. He was brilliant at that. Absolutely brilliant. Followed by the great Larry Grayson. He was really good at it. Jim Davidson. Sorry, no. Didn't do it for me at all. Just didn't like Jim Davidson doing The Generation Gun. I'm sure some people did. Just not my cup of tea, you know. Right, let's just go to the top there. Paris likes the one on Little Britain. Yeah, but no, but yeah, but you're not. Yeah, but no, but yeah, but the one in the tracksuit, Paris. That's the one, isn't it? Sharon used to come to the Monday night oldies and trash night. Do you remember when they brought the two drag queens in, Sharon? Oh, it was just didn't work, did it? Well, actually, one was okay. One was okay. But the other one, Sam, that was his name, wasn't it? Sam. And you know what? He'd come in the pub for years, and then he put this, and he was a nice boy. And then one day they brought him in this drag thing, complete change of personality, total and utter change of personality. And then they got rid of him. I never saw him again. Never saw him after that. Strange, isn't it, really? Yeah, very strange indeed. All right. Okay, boys and girls, we're going to wrap up now because we've got to go swimming. Oh,
and then
on
they
a
got rid of him.
I keep doing that, don't I? Let's do today's birthdays, boys and girls. Might be back tonight. I'm not sure yet. We might actually be back tonight with a show, a late night show today, okay? Here come today's birthdays, and there's quite a few of them today. All right, so here we go. Danny Gibbs is 39 today. Happy birthday to you, Danny. I do miss our little Saturdays and Sundays out where we used to go to that club, don't you? Oh, gosh. I do miss that. Happy birthday to you, Danny. Claricea. Oh, Claricea. Are you Claricea in Manchester? You might be. If you're not, then I apologise. I've mixed you up with someone. Claricea Angeloni. Claricea Angeloni is 42 today. Happy birthday, darling. Brandon. Little Brandon, 21 years old today. Gosh, how long have I known you on the internet? Brandon is 21 years old today. Brandon, who's everything about his life is wonderful, except he lives in Croydon. Oh, dear. You must try and work your way out of that one, darling. Happy birthday, Brandon. Okay, Trevor Lloyd, 69 years old today. Happy birthday, Trevor. Excellent. Darren Hodson, happy birthday. Simon Courtling, who used to come along to the karaoke. Simon, I don't know if you know, but this week it's karaoke on Sunday night in Sydenham if you're coming down there at the Golden Lion, OK? So this Sunday, it's the first Sunday of the month. So that's Sunday, the 5th of March, 2017, karaoke at the Golden Lion in Sydenham, all right? If you come along there, there's happy birthday, Simon. Nancy Minga. Or Minja, Minga, M-I-N-G-A, 29 years old today. Happy birthday, Nancy. And you, Andrew Dubert, 53 years old today. Lovely picture of you in that old Rainbow Union Jack there. Happy birthday. Chris Cronin, happy birthday. Claire Louise Angeloni is 42 today. Gloria Goldberg, what a lovely name. 41 today. Has someone put all these foreign names to trip me up today? Is that what's going on there? Camioetu Solitario, 47. I'm sorry, I'm not very good at pronouncing foreign names. I do my best for you, okay? Happy birthday to Otis Baxter. Hello, Otis, 47 today. I haven't seen you for a while, sir. Joe Simmons from Topping and Butch. Happy birthday. No age on there, Joe, I noticed. Are you hiding something, lovey? Are you hiding something, Joe? Claire Louise. Hang on a minute. Claire, haven't we done that one already? Claire Louise Angeloni. You've got about three profiles there, dear. Well, I'll do them all for you anyway. Happy birthday. And Paul Wilkinson is 42 today. Happy birthday, Paul. And finally, Nick Bedford. Hello, Nick, who's 42 years old today. Happy birthday to you all. Here comes the song. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you. Enjoy your birthday, whatever you do. I'm off for a swim now. Just finally, before we go, the final lot of messages coming in. Sharon says, have a nice swim. I'm off to watch the giraffe having her baby live on Facebook. Yeah, I saw that. There's a link there. You'll have to look for it. There's actually a video, a streaming video of a giraffe having a baby, which is quite nice. Thank you very much. And that's it. All right. Thank you very much, boys and girls, for joining us on the show today. I'll see you on the next one. Have a lovely Tuesday. Bye-bye now.